And so my life began. Junior lobby boy in training, Grand Budapest Hotel, under the strict command of Monsieur Gustave H.
I'm afraid that's me, darling.
I had this thought that I wanted to make a film inspired by Lubitsch, 30s type American comedies made by Europeans.
Does it mean by any chance, Father, that you don't like me?
Son, I love you. Now shut up and leave me alone.
The hotel represents something fine and cultivated and civilized and sophisticated from another time.
One of the charms of this movie is that it revisits a golden age. It's like something from 1930 that you always dreamed you would be and that Fred Astaire was doing, only you're doing it.
Let me make a few calls.
They go on a real adventure, like in a classic way, with snow and guns and explosions and jail and running and fighting for what's right, that it distorted through Wes's unique lens.
It feels like this film is an original 50s film about an amazing hotel. It just has this generosity and this beautiful emotion in the film, which isn't really around that much anymore.
Now, wait a minute. You can't arrest him simply because he's a bloody immigrant.
Take your hands off my lobby boy!
Wes's worlds are always so bold and clear, and the characters are all there. They're all like little chips off of Wes's perception of the universe.
Getting to work with him is also an experience of getting to access Wes's almost like mental library of films or books or photo books that have informed it. And you end up watching 8 films that are all great that you've never heard of.
This is where the director hangs out. A lot of reference material, things that apply sort of to the hotel.
Lubitsch.
There was a scene we shot that had a bunch of Hollywood trickery in it, where the car comes at the camera, the car turns away from the camera goes up, and the car enters up above. But you actually do it with 2 cars. That's one continuous shot. Like the new movie making is the old movie making. Like you throw yourself back and you realize how simple it was.
Get in!
We shot the 30s part of the film in 1:37, which is kind of the frame of the day. You know, those more of a square frame. I hadn't really worked in that format before. It just affords a lot of interesting compositions. For Wes and myself, it was a lot of fun to work in that format.
Action.
I think it's amazing that he can keep surprising you, which is what this movie does on all levels. It's so visually stunning, and the story is just as exciting as the visuals.